Well, welcome back. So, time to take care of grass. That is to cut the grass and get some hay starting. And we've had a bit of an issue with okay, we're gonna do that because I want to stop here. No, go back. Okay. I wish there was a way that you could sort of just press one button to get everything up, instead of having to go, select the forward, and then select the whatever. Now, let's see if the worker will actually do what he's supposed to do and go until the end and come back, and I'm gonna miss a little bit all the way through. No, that's not gonna make me happy. That's gonna make me unhappy. Okay, so we'll do it like this. And this way we shouldn't be missing anything. He should be going all the way to the end, not missing anything. I just hope that he doesn't do what he did before, and that he gets to the end and just stops there. So what do you think he's gonna do? I mean, this barnyards yards looks pretty cool, don't they? I still haven't purchased the truck, so we can carry all our cows to their required sales point. But we will when time comes. I mean, where are we as far as they've got food? They got food some. They've got food some. They got food. Okay, we've got 60 of them, but they're not. 21 months and 21 months, so you got 60 of them, but so we'll leave them be. Please don't just stand there. See, the work is still there, but it's not there, if that makes sense. Why am I getting painting? What do we have? I'm getting this little grass over here, and I thought I saw some. Let's see if I can cut all this grass, and then I'll put it on. I'll put it on. Oh, get out of the way, get out of there, get out of there. I'll put it on Courseplay. See if Courseplay will do a better job. I don't think it could do any worse a job. Oh, come on. Come on, why are we missing all of that? At least this way we're not really gonna have any issues. And we own all the lands, all the way down. Now, I don't really need to worry too much about collecting all the grass. After all, we got grass galore. But let's just pretend that this is a way where we're maintaining the side of our fields, and this way we're kind of looking after our the moisture and making sure that weeds don't just absorb all our moisture for no reason. So yeah, that's the purpose of what we're doing right now, is maintenance. But at the same time, we're going to use it for our animals. So maintenance with a purpose, not just maintenance without a purpose. I love the way the fact that the trees, even though they're outside the map, they're still growing. So they're still growing. They're still, going with the season. So, they're green when they should be green. They turn this bright orange when they should be bright orange, and so on. How far do we have till we? Oh, we got quite a bit to go. So obviously, we're gonna get grass galore. I could probably just have enough grass just by doing this, maintaining maintaining all my fields. If I do that, I should have enough grass, I reckon, just the sidelines of all the fields that I own. Now that we just about own the whole map, I don't think we're gonna struggle for grass at all. So, you know, I mean, what I'm doing is not unrealistic. You have plenty of farmers in real life. From what I see in America, especially a lot of counties, the farmers seem to be responsible for America and Canada. I've seen that some farmers, but they're responsible for maintaining some part of the road as if, you know, as if it's there, as if you belong to them. Who knows? Maybe it does belong. And it's just the way the regulations are in that particular part of the world. But I mean, we have the same rule here in Australia, not on farms. 6 meters of your land belongs to the government, the council. They do nothing for it. You pay rates. So you pay them for the luxury of you having your own land, which you give to them. Right, and then for that luxury, you can't even utilize it. Like, you can't even park your car on it, because if you park your car, the council would come in, fine you, and tell you that the reason that they're fining you. Hey, what are you doing? What are you doing? What are you doing? The reason that they're fining you is because you are parking on their land. Do they maintain that? No. Do they look after it? No. Do they take it off your taxes when you pay taxes for your land? No. So I suppose it's a way where it's really rotten, the way where you buy the land from, well, the government sells the land to somebody, that somebody develops it. You buy the land of the developer thinking you're getting, like in Australia now, you can get as little as 300 some square meters for a land, and people put a, I don't know, 300 square meter house, two stories, so there's pretty much no land at all. You're pretty much your house is right next to the other person's house. So you buy the land, you pay for the whole whatever square meters, and the government pinches some of that off you, the local government, that is, and you get the luxury of paying tax on the land that they supposedly own. You own, but they own, if you know what I mean. And then you can't utilize that at all, other than paying them taxes. So when it comes to you using that land, it's not yours. You can't use it. They'll fine you if you even park your car or anything like that on it. But when it comes to taxes, it's yours again, and you're paying taxes for that land. So you tell me how that works. I got fined 3 times for once parking on my driveway while my wife parked on the driver for like a minute while she ran into the house. And the council has now, they have the luxury of technology where they don't even bother to get out. They just drive down the street and take photos of your car and whatever. And if you park where you shouldn't be, 2 weeks later, boom, you get the luxury of a fine. And they remind you nicely that that you parked on their land until the taxes comes, and then it's your land. So the beauty, right, the bureaucracy and the beauty of bureaucracy. And I suppose governments no longer care about the people in the sense of looking after the people. We are just there for them to collect money from us, and sadly that's what seems to happen. You know, I'd understand if you know, they would say, well, you're blocking, people can't walk past, but that's not the case. But anyway, enough what am I complaining, maybe, but yeah, anyway, it's funny the subject that I got into just by talking about maintaining the sides of the side of your fields. So Christmas is coming, whatever, but plans have you got? And I know I've put some videos out with some Christmas music. Maybe some of you will think, well, that's a bit early, but you know, I thought about it. And I don't think we get to celebrate Christmas as long as it should be. I mean, we don't really celebrate it the way it should be, but anyway, that's a whole point. Whole different thing, kettle of fish, as they say in Australia. So I don't know, should I be cutting the grass up and down up to the end? It kind of just, I don't know, makes it a bit fun, I suppose. So what I'll do is I'll do a bit of time lapse. I don't think you want me to blab on about complaining about governments and all this sort of nonsense. So we'll do a bit of a time lapse now.
Joy to the world, the Lord is come. Let earth receive her King. Prepare him room, and heaven and nature sing, and heaven and nature sing, and heaven and nature sing. Joy to the world, the Savior reigns. Let men their songs employ, while fields and floods, rocks, hills and plains, repeat the sounding joy, repeat the sounding joy, repeat, repeat the sounding joy. Truth and grace, and makes the nations prove the glories of his righteousness, and wonders of his love, and wonders of his love, and wonders, wonders of his love.
Stuck here. So I have no idea why he seems to get stuck here. So I'm hoping that this time he'll do the work that he needs to do. So we'll check up on him later. I want to go. No, actually, I think it's here somewhere, right there. Okay, it says there's no more space. How is there no more space? Is it because of the truck? I don't know if it's because of the truck. The truck is in the way. But I should be able to see my egg, the eggs that the chickens have. Nothing there, really. So what was it going on about before saying there's no more space? So where are we? October. When is the best price for eggs? I think it's December. 417 in November. And what's it now? 4145 at the bakery. And whatever at the October. Okay, what I'll do is I will go. Okay, we here. And we will sleep and wake up at 9 a.m. And then we'll go and sell the eggs. Okay, so go over here. Okay, so. And I left the beacons going on the whole night. There we go. I realize that it's designed in such a way where it will not pick the the pallet that are empty type of thing. Well, empty, that's a silly thing to say. It will not collect anything that is not 100% filled up. We got some stuff there, but that's okay. We'll go sell the eggs. And once we sell the eggs, we'll look at whatever we need to do. As far as... I said I'll put a road over here, but I haven't as yet. We'll need to see what we need to do as far as getting ourselves ready for production. I mean, pretty soon, we're going to have a humongous amount of crops. And I believe we have something in November that we can sell at top price type of thing. See, this is where I need to cut some of these trees down. Let's see, can we go through? If we can go this way. Well, cut some of those trees down and just put a road straight through here. Yeah, we can sell some of our crops, but you know, we have weeds. Pretty sure I have weeds turned off. Get ourselves some production that we can utilize crop. For more than just, feeding the chickens, or... Actually, I think it's over here that I need to sell. Oh, there you are, this is ready. So we got some crops that we need to get ourselves into harvesting mode. So what do you got? $21,000, roughly. So let's see what happens when we sell all the eggs. So over $100,000, obviously, about $115,000-ish. So that's not bad. That's not bad at all. So let's see what... What crops? Oh, come on, come on, come on. What's ready to... Okay, so just that field is ready to harvest, which is... barley. So what do we have as far as production is concerned? But nothing that... okay, this is milk. That's... Okay, so we can do soybeans, oats over there. Chocolate or sugar. I don't know how to get sugar. Okay, we need to look into... I may end up selling all of these things and just put something else instead of them. Clothing. So not a lot of clothing. Well, we don't have a lot of fabric either. So, fabric. Okay, so... we don't have a lot of it either. So that's fine. It's fine. We've got quite a bit of preparation to get myself into. So I need to look into how do I get sugar. obviously it would have something to do with sugarcane. And you know what? We got sugarcane galore on one of our fields. So that's going to be fun. And we need to start looking into that. So our production then becomes more than just, you know, we do whatever and just wool and milk. I mean, after all, this map is going to become very, very, very boring very quickly. I mean, I say the word boring, but you know what? I enjoy playing this. I normally don't enjoy playing map with really massive fields. But for whatever reason, this map has an appeal. Like, I've tried even the Western Australian map and a couple of... I forget the other Australian map that... You know, massive fields. And don't get me wrong, it was good. You know, fields were nice. And but I couldn't really play it more than two or three episodes. And then I kind of... It kind of just became overwhelming. It's true that the fields were massive compared to these. You know, like... And that says something when I say massive compared to this, because this is a decent size, field, fields on this map. But I just couldn't do it. And yet here I am playing this map, and really no problems at all. I actually still enjoy playing it, and I believe we're up to what, 24, 25 episodes already. So anyhow. Thank you very much for spending some time with me. I hope you enjoyed this episode. Have a wonderful day wherever you are around the world. God bless you, and we'll see you in the next episode. Bye-bye. God bless you and your family. Bye-bye.